and sisters, the Lord is with you.
And also with you.
We continue listening to God speak to us from the Gospel in the tradition of Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We have seen his star at its rising, and have come to do him homage." When Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. He then called together the chief priests and the scribes of the people to find out where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah, since from you will come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and pay homage.' After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that had seen rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way." And this is the gospel, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
By the words of the gospel, may our sins be blotted out.
Amen.
So we gather on this, technically, the day of Epiphany, January 6th. And we know the story. We've heard the gospel time after time, year after year. And it's an interesting read, of course. And it fits the whole season of Christmas. And we're still in the Christmas season, technically, until February 2nd, which is the Feast of the Presentation. A couple of things that I just want to bring your attention to before I go in a little bit further. The only place in the Gospels that we hear of these three visits is the Gospel of Matthew. That's it. And then after the scripture says they departed for their country by another route, that's it. We never hear of them again. Never. Read someplace in, there are many other Gospels that are not contained in our scripture. And in other Gospels, it states that when Jesus was crucified, one of these visitors was also there. That could be kind of a myth. As I said, the interesting thing, only in Matthew. And how come only in Matthew? Didn't the other ones think, why Matthew? And as we've said to you many times, Father Vinny and myself, is that each of the Gospels was written for a particular audience, a particular group of people. And the Gospel of Matthew was written specifically for a Jewish community. And what he's trying to do is to show that this child was not just for the Jewish community, but that this child was and is the light for the world. And then something else that just, every time I read it, I try to find something different. One thing we know is that this particular event in the life of Jesus did not occur 12 days after Christmas, after he was born. It would have been impossible. They saw the star in a country that was probably thousands of miles away from Bethlehem. They didn't jump on the jet. They traveled, camels, caravans. And the scripture says that on entering the house, there's no mention of a stable. Entering the house, and they did homage with the gifts. Now, the symbol of light isn't just a Christian thing. Okay? In the Hebrew scriptures, there are so many references to light. For example, Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The word of light to lead your path and the lamp to guide you. This is all the concept of what we're celebrating today. That Christ is our light. And each one of us is asked every day to proclaim that light to others. And it's not just something we do at this time of the year. And if it is, well then we've got some theology that's a little mixed up. And what we're asked to do, very simply, is to take the idea given to us that where Jesus was born, for us to realize that that particular place on the map of Bethlehem is right here with you and me. That's where the Word became flesh, where Emmanuel was given to us. And as we gather in this space here tonight, this afternoon, before I came here, I was just drawn to visit our new home. And myself and Father Vinny, we just revel in it. And it's going to be quite a place. It's going to be quite a place for us to make a new home for our parish, for our part of the Catholic Church, and for us to truly be a light in that area. It's a tremendous opportunity we have. And it's up to each one of us to make sure that that light follows us. It's a challenge. And we're up to the challenge. I want you to think of something. When Mary was asked to be the mother of the Messiah, I wonder if she knew what was going to transpire. How she was going to see her son praised, spit upon, crucified. Would she have still said yes? That's a question given to us. Will we say yes each time we're asked to project God's light? Please, God, we will. Pray for me as I pray for you. And may God bless us and keep us. May God's face shine upon us and give us peace. Now and always.
Amen. Amen.